Hello, wrist blood pressure monitors. Well, wrist blood pressure monitors have actually grown in popularity in the last couple of years. But the question is this, do they actually do what they are designed for? That is to say, do they give you accurate blood pressure readings? That's what this video is about. I want to say a word or two about wrist blood pressure monitors versus upper arm blood pressure monitors, okay? The key phrase there is accurate blood pressure readings. Do these wrist monitors actually give you accurate blood pressure readings? That's what this video is about, so stay tuned and I'll see you shortly after the channel intro.
If you want 2020 ideas to better health, you've come to the right channel, hosted by the warm and lovely Dr. Joe. Now, for today's topic, please welcome on stage, Dr. Joe.
Welcome back. I'm Dr. Joe of the drjoe.com. So wrist blood pressure monitors are growing in popularity. Everybody seems to be buying them and using them to monitor their blood pressure at home. That's not a bad thing. But I'm really concerned about what those wrist blood pressure monitors are delivering, all right, compared to this stuff, all right? This is the upper arm monitors, all right? So I'll start with the positives. Well, the wrist blood pressure monitors, they're easy to use. So long as you can actually wrap a wristwatch around your wrist, you can use them. They're just like a wristwatch. You just wrap them around, you know, and off you go. You get your blood pressure reading. So they're very easy to use, all right? There's no dexterity involved in actually using them. The second thing is they are very portable because they are smaller than this one, all right, than the upper arm monitors. So they're very easy to fit into your bag and off you go. If you're traveling, you can take them along with you. But that is not to say these are bulky. I mean, these ones, they're also very easy to carry around. But in comparison to the upper arm monitors, they're smaller. So I'll give that to them. Now, accuracy of blood pressure readings, because that's the most important factor in all of this. Do they give accurate blood pressure readings? So I'll tell you a story. I first came across wrist blood pressure monitors a couple of years ago, about 4, 5, 6 years ago. I saw a full page ad in a newspaper and talking about these wrist blood pressure monitors. I thought, oh, that's a great idea. And I thought, I'll get one. So I got one for myself. It arrived in the post a couple of days later, and I was very keen to get on with it. So I applied them and I was getting some really wild blood pressure readings on the left arm. Or left wrist, I should say. And then, I did it twice. I was getting really close readings, like 240 over 160 millimeters of mercury. I thought, that's all right. And then I transferred to the right wrist. Same thing. I was getting wild readings. Of course, because I have this one at home, all right, I double checked with that and I was getting low readings. At the time, my blood pressure was well controlled. So I didn't believe the readings I was getting from them. So I called the retailer, and they said, oh, okay, maybe that's a dodgy one. Okay, so they said I should send it back. I sent it back to them. They sent me another one, the same result. Nothing changed, so I sent it back. And I bought some more brands ever since at the time. And I tried them, and to be honest, I got the same wild readings. So the point is, they don't give accurate readings. In terms of accuracy, they fail on that one. If you get decent readings, that's probably sporadic. You need something you can rely on, all right? So, accuracy, there's a very big doubt about wrist blood pressure monitors as far as accuracy of blood pressure readings is concerned. Now, just to underscore the point about accuracy, let me give you a review, what I'll call an honest review by a customer from that popular retailing website. And so this customer wrote, and I quote, he says, I'm really disappointed with this product. The readings were wildly off compared to my doctor's blood pressure monitor, and it was dubious to say the least. I want to return this product and get a full refund. That's what I call an honest review. So, why do the wrist monitors give unreliable readings? Well, for a start, the wrist blood pressure monitors, they are ultra sensitive to the body's position compared to the upper arm monitors. So that's the first reason. The second reason is, when you're trying to measure your blood pressure, the cuffed part of the body, whether it's the wrist or the arm, it should be at the level of the heart. And as you can tell, this is not a very natural position for the wrist, All right. Sometimes you may want to adjust it, this arm or you know this wrist or the other wrist. It's not a very natural position for the wrist to be in. For the arm is already at the level of the heart, so all it needs is just a little bit of elevation, and you're right there. Okay. So and this is a natural position for the upper arm. Right. So that's the second point. Now the third point is that the artery that you're trying to measure the blood pressure of. With the wrist monitor is called the radial artery. The radial artery is narrower and is a lot more superficial compared to the brachial artery from which you're taking the blood pressure off with the upper arm monitors. The brachial artery is bigger and is more deeply set compared to the radial artery that is more superficial and narrower. So the blood pressure readings you get from the radial artery are usually higher compared to the brachial artery. It then begs the question, why do people go for the wrist blood pressure monitors instead of using the regular, you know, upper arm monitors? Well, one reason is this. Some people have a big arm, in which case this regular size cuff won't do. It's gonna give abnormally high readings. So they then go for the wrist blood pressure monitor because it doesn't require a huge cuff. Well, the way around that is you go online and search for a big cuff for upper arm monitors, all right? So you just buy a bigger cuff, that's all right? So that takes care of that problem. Indeed, if you go online, you're gonna see a lot of options for you to buy the bigger cuff. So that takes care of that problem. The other issue is that to use the upper arm monitors, it does require a certain amount of dexterity. And some people have issues with that. So here's what I say. What you need to do is always thread the free end of the cuff through the metal guide, all right? Always thread it all the time, have it threaded through. And then all you then need to do is when you're gonna measure your blood pressure, you just slip your hand through, your forearm through as well. And then slide it up, all right? You slide it up, and then because it's already threaded through, all you then need to do is fasten, okay? Simple as that, all right? Have it threaded through like this, ready to go, and you'll be fine. Well, you might think by virtue of this video presentation that I am anti-innovation. Well, I'm not. Nothing could be further from the truth. The thing is, I'm all for innovation, but if innovation does not come with reliability, I'll be asking myself the question, what is the point? I've tested a lot of these wrist blood pressure monitors, and in my opinion, they failed the reliability test. It's for that reason I will not recommend the wrist blood pressure monitors for you if you're watching this video. Stick with these upper arm monitors, okay? You know, they are reliable, they give more accurate readings so long as they're well calibrated. All right, these are the ones that I recommend, the upper arm monitors. Ask yourself this, when was the last time you went into a hospital or a doctor's office and you saw them using the wrist blood pressure monitors? Okay, you know, after all, these wrist blood pressure monitors have been around for a good number of years. Why haven't they made their way into the hospital environment? It's for that same reason, they're not reliable. Because they're very convenient to use and we should be using them in hospitals, but we don't. And it's because they're not reliable. Right. By the way, I've done a video on the checklist, the guidelines for getting, you know, your blood pressure measurement right every time. The video should be up there now. Okay. See if you can watch it. And also, I've also done a video on, you know, the simple things that you can do, simple things in life that you can do that will help you to reduce your blood pressure. The video should be up there now as well. Okay. As soon as you finished watching this video, please watch those other two videos, all right? Well, if you like this video presentation or you think someone you know might benefit from actually watching this video, please share this video with them, okay? Share the video with them. And also hit the like button, all right? If you liked what I did here, hit the like button. Oh, by the way, I should say this. This is not about brands. It's nothing to do with brands, okay? This is about reliability, all right? If you haven't subscribed to this wonderful channel, please do hit the subscription button. It's right there, all right? It takes only a few seconds to subscribe. I think that's about it as far as this video is concerned. If you've got something to say, say it in the comment section, all right? Some people might say what I've said here might be controversial. Well, go ahead. Leave your comments in the comment section. I think that's about it as far as this video is concerned. Until next time, well, this is Dr. Joe signing out.